जनरल नारायणन, कमांडेंट एमसीएमई, मिस्टर रघुराम रेड्डी, प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ द सिकंदराबाद सेलिंग क्लब, डिग्निटरीज ऑन एंड ऑफ द डेज, पार्टिसिपेंट्स, लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, इट्स गिव्स मी इमेंस प्लेजर, इट्स अ ग्रेट ऑनर फॉर मी टू बी हियर टू शेयर दिस स्टेज विद ऑल ऑफ यू एंड स्पेंड सम टाइम विद यू. मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंटली गिव्स मी अ गुड एक्सक्यूज टू गेट आउट ऑफ द हीट ऑफ दिल्ली एंड बी विद यू. बट most importantly, I'm very happy to be here to share some moments with the enthusiastic yachting community from all across the country. I'm also very glad that we could start doing some real yachting after a very long time. And I compliment all participants and organizers of this event for having overcome the challenges of COVID. It's a no mean challenge. It's a very difficult days for us, and to get this event done was great work done. For all the participants, you know, staying away from a sport that you love and you live for is extremely difficult, and especially in sailing, because you require to constantly hone your skills and do a lot of practice. It requires a lot of practice because you have to master this very challenging issue of harnessing the winds. You have to be ready to wait patiently to overcome a particular lull patch, then tighten your sheets, or maybe even shorten your sails when the gusts start. All that you have done admirably, and I think slightly monsoonic conditions must have given you pretty nice winds to challenge you as you went along with the competition. Personally, I have sailed the Enterprise at a very basic level. Crewed the catamaran, and I've been a very enthusiastic windsurfer. These experiences have led me to admire yachtsmen all along, because they are the ones who use their intuition, their skill, and instincts to harness the waves and the winds. And you know, in the Navy, we have huge ships, we've got a lot of power, but we always tell people that you need to know sailing, because you cannot fight the forces of nature. You got to respect them. And this is what sailing teaches you all. You often experience winds that are never steady, and they change direction just when you require them, the waves that bring their own challenges, yet you have to sort of harmonize with nature and stay on course. And in the boat, there are no books or apps or almanacs to guide you. It's all your instincts and your skill that gives you. So I really want to compliment all of you for being participating in this sport. I am also sure that the past week would have enriched you both in and out of the water. When you take part in a race, or the invaluable race experience that you derive from such races, the interaction that you have with senior sailors, the mentors and the coaches, they go a long way in shaping your future. And no matter what the results, I'm sure that all of you who have taken part in this have become better sailors in one way or the other. Here I would like to congratulate the award winners for their performance, and hope that this success keeps spurring them on to greater heights, as also inspiring all those youngsters who want to follow in your wake. I got to meet some of you when I came in, and I'm sure your performances are going to motivate the rest to follow in your wake. The Hyderabad Sailing Week was established in 1986 and has produced, as General Narasimhan said, produced numerous sailors of national and international repute. And therefore, the efforts of EME Sailing Associations, which have transformed this annual event into a national ranking event with the presence of international jury, is something which is commendable. Big round of applause to them. So as one of the most awaited events in the YEI sporting calendar, I hope the Hyderabad Sailing Week continues to rise in stature, expand in participation, and attract the best talent in our country, and provide the perfect launch pad for our budding yachtsmen. The success of the Hyderabad Sailing Week is also a testimony, like I mentioned, for the perseverance and dedication of the organizers, the EME Sailing Association. And as the president of the Yachting Association of India, I place on record my appreciation to the organizing committee for having made this event possible, and General Narayanan for leading his team through some tough situations. I also thank all the volunteers who worked tirelessly to make this behind the scenes, to provide all the young sailors the well-deserved opportunity to get back to sailing. I'm confident that the collective resilience that you have all shown will go a long way in cementing India as a credible powerhouse in the field of yachting. You know, yachting has been steadily growing, not at the pace that we wanted to, but now, having seen what happened in the Tokyo Olympics, I think it should be a shot in the arm for sailing. Having four sailors who have qualified competitively for Tokyo Olympics, I met Netra, Vishnu, Ganpati, and Varun in Delhi, and in Rashtrapati Bhavan when the president met them, and I found that the president, the prime minister, and the sports minister were extremely proud of the fact, first of all, that Netra was the first woman who has gone to Olympics and to these yachtsmen who competitively got into the fray. So I think this is a great opportunity and a great accomplishment for all of us, and we must now move ahead on this, and I'm confident that all of you who have taken part, many of you, will reach higher heights and get better accolades for this country. So finally, for borrowing from the Tokyo Olympics motto of united by emotion, I would reword it to say united by passion, and that is should reflect the bond amongst this audience, and the events like this, like Hyderabad Sailing Week, should continue to ignite more minds, Indian minds, to take on yachting as a sport. So great work done, and I'd like to end by wishing all of you present here and all the participants happy sailings and fair winds. Thank you. Jai Hind.